off the tube and welcome back to January, the only month last year when I made any Doctor Who related content at all. Apart from, actually, February. Almost all of February was also Doctor Who. But we don't talk about Feb Blu-ray. I actually have a Blu-ray player now, so I could watch some Feb Blu-ray Blu-rays in Feb Blu-ray. Maybe I will. But that's not what this video is. It's not February. We're not talking about Blu-rays. Welcome back to January. But no, I just had a notion that I kind of wanted to make this video. I was watching the review of Death, also not sponsored, although if you want a guest who no one has any interest in and is not able to stay on topic, my schedule's always free. But yeah, I was watching the review of Death. It was a Christmas edition and they were doing a Q&A and someone was asking them what their particular thing that made them of interest to listen to others was, and they were saying about how the fact that they'd gotten into Doctor Who in the wilderness years, and that was quite a specific period. Generally, you've got your new Who fans and you've got your old Who fans. And it just made me think, different people, we've all gotten in, you know, if we're into Doctor Who, which I suspect anyone that's watching a video with Doctor Who in the title is probably into Doctor Who, we probably all got into it at different times and in different ways. I just thought it might interest some of you to hear the story of how I got into Doctor Who, because it's dominated my life for the last nearly 17 years. You know, there are people who are just pretty much adults that were born when I got into Doctor Who, and that's bizarre, but it wasn't always. When I was less than 12 and three quarters, I didn't really know Doctor Who. And because my age was high enough that, you know, I was nearly a teenager at this point, I was old enough that I can remember quite strongly the moment when Doctor Who became a thing in my life. And it's probably not the obvious thing that you're thinking of, except maybe it kind of is, but not directly. So as I said, I got into the show when I was 12 and three quarters. I was born in the summer of 1992, so doing your maths, that puts you to spring 2005, and obviously Doctor Who came back that year. We had the revival, series one, Christopher Eccleston, and I had no real reason to be interested in. That wasn't necessarily going to be something that would interest me because I didn't know Doctor Who back then. I had encountered Doctor Who initially in the form of the Peter Cushing movie. I saw the first one, not the second one. I knew there was a second one, I hadn't seen it. And I saw the Peter Cushing Doctor Who and the Daleks when I was maybe 9 or 10. And I remember that. I remember very clearly we had it recorded off the television. I watched it quite a few times. I liked it. I thought it was great. I mean, obviously, I've still got my wild camera work there. You can see him up there. My big, that Dalek I made a couple of years back during the lockdown. So that was my first exposure to Doctor Who at all. But obviously, that's not the TV show. I didn't know there was a TV show. I had no idea. I thought Doctor Who is Doctor Who and the Daleks. It's this quirky little old film with the angry robots. That's it. That's Doctor Who. And I remember in 2003 or 2004, whenever it was they announced the show was coming back, because it was quite a while beforehand, I remember seeing in a paper, there was a little thing at the side saying, would you believe Doctor Who's coming back? And there's a picture of Tom Baker, and it was just saying Doctor Who is coming back, and it mentioned, you know, this, enough that I could gleam, this is a TV show called Doctor Who. And I was like, okay, well, that film was Doctor Who and the Daleks, so this must be the TV series. And I remember mentioning it to my mother, and saying, hey, this might be something I'd be interested in. I like that film, Doctor Who and the Daleks. I'd probably like that. And she's like, no, I don't think you'd like it. No, it's not much like that film at all. You wouldn't like it. So I really strongly remember this because it's funny because, big twist, turns out I did like it. Moving on a couple of years, Doctor Who was coming back. It was filmed. It was ready to be broadcast in around about Easter time of 2005. It was in March, I think. It was when we'll get to this. So anyway, spring rolls around. It's not quite time yet, or it's probably late winter time. There was a variety of things being shown on the television just to kind of generate a bit of interest and draw in some of the older fans to be like, hey, remember Doctor Who? Well, also here's an advert for Doctor Who coming back. Put these two images together in your mind. We're doing Doctor Who. And there was a documentary, I think it was a repeat, actually, of a documentary from a couple of years earlier. Maybe I'd say probably 2003. They had a documentary just covering the original series from Hartnell to McCoy. and just covered the TV series as a running series, and it started with, it went quite in depth. The programme was about maybe an hour. They had interviews with all the people you'd expect, you know, all the surviving doctors. Terence Dix, of course, was there. Just all the good people that you like to see. And this programme was on, and it was being recorded by someone else in the house, and I noticed that was being recorded. I thought, I wonder what this is all about, this program that's recording right now. I don't know why, but I flicked in just to see where it was. I got there quite early in. They're still talking about Hartnell at that point. And I just sat there and I was like, yeah, this seems interesting. And I watched it and I kept on watching it. And there was just more and more and more. And there was just, that was it. That was the moment. Because it looked just so much like something I could really sink my teeth into and get really worked up and obsessed about. It excited me so much. I don't think anything had excited me up until that point as much as this random documentary. I think it's on YouTube, actually. I might, if I can find that exact documentary, I'll link it in the description, because that was it. It wasn't the new series, it was the rerun of the documentary about the classic series that they put on in advance of the new series. And I watched it, and I was like, this is everything. I need this in my life. And I was like, well, I know that they're bringing it back. It's coming back soon. That's so I can watch the new one when it comes on, and I can look up every scrap of information I can find out about the original version, because that was what, you know, that was what I was most excited about. Interestingly, I remember watching it. My favourite, I mean, I was basing my favourite on just these little clips and snippets I'd seen. My favourite was McCoy. I liked his hat and his umbrella. I thought that's neat. I like that. And I remember on holiday in March that year, I went off to Spain, and I was, you know, I was still young enough to be playing like pretend games, and I was pretending to be the Doctor from Doctor Who. I was pretending to be Sylvester McCoy Doctor. I had a hat. It was a hat a bit like this, but it wasn't this hat. And I had the brim turned up, and I had my spade from like a bucket and spade, and that was my umbrella. And I was just doing Doctor Who. This thing I just discovered at the age of 12. I'll be honest, probably too old to be playing pretend games, but I was always a bit like young for my age. So that was it. That was the moment. And then the series came back. Episode 1 aired the day that we flew out. Episode 2 aired halfway through the holiday, and episode 3 aired the night we flew back, and we missed it again. So I watched all three of those. You know, episode 3 aired on the Saturday. I watched them all probably on the Sunday or the Monday at latest. But that begs the question, because the first Doctor Who that I actually watched was Series 1. That was a show that I began watching, and I loved it. I was really, really hooked. I loved Christopher Eccleston as the Doctor. I still do. I was really sad when he left, but I was excited about the new Doctor. All that stuff that you expect getting into Doctor Who. I did all of that. It was a new series I started watching, but it was the classic series that caught my interest. But I didn't actually start watching the classic series itself until early 2007, sort of January, maybe February 2007. We'd just gotten the internet. And back then, for people that are very young, you might not know this, but in the early days of YouTube, copyright, just, it was a free-for-all. Anything could be up there. There was so much classic Doctor Who on YouTube, just uploaded by just people on a whim. It wasn't uploaded by the BBC, it was just random people stuck it up there. You could pretty much watch all of it. It was pretty much all there. And I got through a lot of it. I started in 2007. I hadn't actually set out to watch classic series Doctor Who the day that I did. You know, we just recently got the internet. I was watching just whatever came to mind. I was looking up Doctor Who on YouTube. I was watching Regeneration Montage. I think it was like one of these sort of video edits that people have done to music. It was to Everyone Changes, you know, everybody changes, but I don't feel the same. But they were showing the various regenerations. It was a video like that. And the next sort of suggested video I saw in the side was Fourth Doctor Regeneration recreated in The Sims. So I watched that. And that, the ending of that was kind of edited like the ending of Logopolis. And then Castle Revolver Part 1, the actual episode, was in the suggested videos. I was like, ooh, well, that's the next episode after this random Sims recreation I've just watched. I'll watch that. I'll watch Castle Revolver. And I watched part 1, and then part 2, and part 3, and part 4. And I was like, I love that. That was great fun. And then I actually went back and watched Logopolis, and then I watched the rest of Series 19, and then I watched Planet of the Spiders, and then Series 12. And that I didn't watch it in order. I watched it in very chaotic, random sequencing. But this is 2007 that I actually started watching the classic series. But the way I see it, although it was the new series that I started watching first, it was the classic series that hooked me in. It was watching a thing about the classic. I wasn't watching the classic series itself, but it was seeing bits. It was edited highlights. It was people talking about it. But that was the thing that hooked me. So arguably, because the new series hadn't started at that point, we're still a few weeks away, I would say that I was brought into Doctor Who through the classic series at about the last possible time that you could get into Doctor Who through the classic series, because once the new series started, anyone that didn't know the show, that was the first thing they were going to see. That was what was currently on. That was the immediate now of Doctor Who. I mean, obviously, Christopher Eccleston's Doctor Who is older now than some of McCoy was back then, which is mad to me. But yeah, it was the classic series that brought me in. So I would say, and feel free to come and contradict me and say, no, this title is me. I think I'm probably just about the last ever person to get into Doctor Who exclusively through the classic series, when the classic series was still just Doctor Who. It was just all of Doctor Who. So that's, I find that quite interesting. It's just a little snippet into things. Doctor Who, since then, 17 years near enough, it's taken over my life. It's a real problem. Send help. But yeah, where would I be without Doctor Who? I don't know. Things would be very different, and I don't think they'd be different for the better. I think they'd just be, that thing would be absent from my life. Up until that point, I used to get really fixated on things for like a little while, and some of them stick around. If they're good enough, I'll still like them. I'll still be into them. Just they won't be my main thing. Monsters, Inc., when that film was released back in the early 2000s, I watched that. I was mad about that for a couple of months. McDonald's, a couple of years later, did a range of Muppet toys for the 25th anniversary of The Muppet Show, and I got super hooked on the Muppets. That was my number one thing, actually, until Doctor Who came along and kind of took over. But the Muppets, still love the Muppets. Muppets is probably my second favourite thing after Doctor Who still. But Doctor Who has, it stood the test of time. It became the new thing that was my new current big thing that I was excited about, and it just stayed there. It stayed the number one thing. Nothing ever came along that took over it. There's other things that I got into after that I like, and the things that I got into after that I still like, but Doctor Who has been my favourite thing ever since that night watching that documentary. And I just think that's interesting. We've all gotten into it at different times. A lot of people who are a fair bit older than me got into it through the classic series and had to sit around waiting during the wilderness years, at whatever age they were when the wilderness years started. There's people, you know, who were like 5, 6, they just got it into the show and then it went off the air. Those people, if they stuck as fans throughout that period, like, well done. I think if I got into something immediately before it got cancelled, I think that would have been a bit disheartening. Although, I mean, Doctor Who is really exciting. And back then, there wasn't the wealth of things, you know, the video range was very minimal. I think if you wanted to revisit old Doctor Who, most of it you had to get the books and wait for the VHS tapes to be released, and then wait another like decade for the DVD range to start. But then you get people who are about my age to a little older to a little younger, who were born at the start of the wilderness years and sort of existed through it. And a lot of those people, if they had UK TV Gold, they could watch Doctor Who reruns. That was the other place you could watch them, is on Gold. I think possibly sometimes BBC Two, but you'd either need to just sort of stumble across it or have someone else in your family that wanted to watch it and put it on for you to sort of be exposed to it. And those people were already fully into Doctor Who when the new series was announced. And then you've got the people who were born either just not long before new series of Doctor Who started, or were born after the new series started. And if they're into Doctor Who, they've gotten into Doctor Who through watching the new series. And there are people now who their entire life, Doctor Who is just, it's been on. Because it's been on for, you know, 17 years now coming up. And anyone who is the age now that I was when I got into Doctor Who, they would have been born round about the time of the David Tennant 2009 specials, which again is so bizarre to me. These people that aren't even old enough to remember when David Tennant was the current Doctor, but they're maybe getting into Doctor Who now, or they got into Doctor Who like in the last few years, and I think that's really exciting. Everyone gets into it at their own time, in their own way, and I think that's lovely. So I'd be interested to know, what's your story? How did you get into Doctor Who? When did you get into Doctor Who? How old were you? Was it the new series that spawned your interest? Or had you managed to catch on to Doctor Who being a thing before it came back? Or are you old enough to remember when Doctor Who was on and hadn't gone off the air yet? Or do you, have you never been into Doctor Who? If so, I mean, I've been rambling for a while now. It's that's like 20 minutes at least. So I don't know what you're watching for, but I hope you found this interesting. Give Doctor Who a try. So yeah, leave me a comment. I'd be interested to know. Maybe make your own video. You know, you don't have to, this doesn't have to be the only video. It's probably not. I'm sure there's plenty of other videos. But yeah, hope you find this interesting, informative. Stay tuned though. Stuff coming eventually. I'll put my car back on again. So stick around for that. Until then though, thank you for watching and have a nice day. See, I was joking earlier about, if the Review of Death wanted a guest that's no one cares about and rambles and can't stick to the point, this video, depending on how well I've edited it, is going to be a prime example, because I just rambles. I'm like, oh, here's a little thread and I'll just follow this, but I'm meant to be over here. Oh gosh, I need to, I'm committed now, I'm going this way. I'll go over there later, and I was heading towards there, but where is my point? What is my point? I could have said this in half the time. I'll try and edit it down, but no promises. Bye.